Hi folks, thanks for tuning into this first video of the series on marriage, romance, and family. Today we're talking about the image of male and female, the image of man and woman. Because, why image? Because you're probably going to need to learn something more than a few tips and tricks to get one's marriage on the right track. You got to see the goal of a good and successful marriage, how it works and what it was meant to be. I, for one, am tired of art that says, this is what marriage is, and it shows you a picture not of marriage, but of divorce. All right, we get the picture. People don't always stay married, we know. But we want to help by showing you what's on the top of the mountain. What is the goal that I'm striving after, that my wife and I are working towards, that we can work towards? What has God made man and woman to be? What is God like? The same question. God shows us what he is like by what he has made, partially. And so what we find here in Genesis chapters 1 and 2 is that God made humans with the nature and the capacity to unite as husband and wife. Let's use the Bible now. Genesis 1:27. God made man in his own image. In the image of God he created him. Male and female he created them. Genesis 2:7. Then the Lord God formed the man of dust from the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and the man became a living creature. Genesis 2:18. The Lord God said, it is not good that the man should be alone. I will make him a helper fit for him. And now for the big one, Genesis 2:21-25. So the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon the man, and while he slept, took one of his ribs and closed it up with flesh. And the rib that the Lord God had taken from the man, he made into a woman and brought her to the man. Then the man said, this is at last bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman because she was taken out of man. Therefore a man shall leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. And the man and his wife were both naked and were not ashamed. There's so much insight. We'll try to keep it as brief as we can for one video. Number one, being a man and being a woman are both good things created by God in paradise, in perfection. Before there were any problems, God decided that man should be man and woman should be woman. And that means if you're a man, then you should not see yourself simply as a default setting that needed to be replaced by a woman. And if you're a woman, you should not see yourself as a secondary setting that's just an afterthought to the man. Rather, man and woman are both good creatures of God that are meant to be what they are meant to be. And there, our relationship to the earth, our relationship to our bodies, our relationship to man and woman, that is emphatically positive, isn't it? We are created from the ground to have masculine or feminine bodies. And all this is right there. Number two, man and woman are supposed to be together. Not to view themselves as at enmity with one another, but cooperating with one another. For this, I think that so many of the problems of our culture today could be solved if men and women could recapture that that friendship. For example, the man who is a misogynist, a predator, a sexual predator, a man who belittles women, who manipulates them, who takes advantage of them, that man is not masculine. That man is turning himself into a tyrant, or an animal, or a pervert. And so, far from being masculine, he is defiling the image of man that he bears. And on the other side of the coin, the woman who seeks to overthrow him and chooses some kind of flag of feminism and takes this to the degree where she's like tapping into secret energies, psychic powers with spirit guides and demons to empower her, she is not being feminine. But because she is falling away from trusting in the true God, she's turning herself into an idolater, someone who worships herself. She's turning herself into a witch. And so these two characters, if you will, are both failing in the same way. They are failing to see the other sex as a creature of God. And they're failing to look at God as their helper and their rescuer in all times of trouble. Let's move on. We have here an order in which male and female were created, right? The man was made first, and the woman was taken out of him. Obviously, therefore, man and woman are made of the same stuff. If the man is made of the earth and the woman is made of the man, then there's an equality there. There's a unity. God's image incorporates male and female, not just one or the other. Now, about this notion that the man was made first and the woman was made second, we see more of this, and we'll get to it when we talk about marriage per se. But it says in Scripture that the husband should see himself and behave himself as if he were the head of his wife and family. So here's this body language. He is to view himself as the head of the body because she is a part of his body. He is to spontaneously and lovingly care for her with all her needs in mind, just as spontaneously he feeds himself and clothes himself and goes after his own desires, right? He should get outside of himself and look to her, and now as this incorporation into his life. This also speaks to the very general fact that a man generally seeks a wife, right? Why? He seeks it as part of completion of his humanity. It's as if it's been taken out of him and he's on the search to find her again. And so he does. It's very true to life, right? And the woman as well. What is she looking for in life? She's looking for a home. She's looking for a secure dwelling place that's cozy enough for her. And she wants to find that in another person, a man, a husband. Now that's just general. I know that many people have been blessed with being single, but this is just in case we're talking about the relationship of man and woman. That's the way it's happening, isn't it? And finally, we see, and when the Lord says, I will make a helper fit for him, that word fit for him in Hebrew kind of means opposite, kind of means a counterpart. It kind of means if you got like one of those goofy kids, two-piece jigsaw puzzles. They ought to fit together. Why? Because man and woman are different from one another because they form a binary whole. His gifts and her gifts complete each other. And she makes up for what he lacks, he makes up for what she lacks, and that's why they fit together. They are opposite. They help each other, and they have to help each other that way. Just as God is our helper and wants us to depend upon him, we depend upon each other interdependently. That's about all for today. Next time we talk, we'll talk about the virtues that somewhat distinguish male and female. Want to know more? Check us out next time. Have a blessed day.